Guys, I'm gonna do a quick empties video just so I can get rid of some of this stuff, throw it out, and make room for just make room in general and get some trash out of my room. Okay, so I'm gonna go through this really quick. There's some skincare, some soap, some makeup, so it's kind of a blend of everything. So I'm just gonna grab right off the top of my box here. So okay, so the first thing I'm grabbing here is the Bath & Body Works Sunlight and Apple Trees, and this was a summer scent, I believe. So this got used up. It's just the foaming hand soap, and it does have a nice apple scent there, so I would get this again next spring or next summer when it's more relevant to the season time and all that, but the next thing I grabbed is from Lush, and it's the Strawberry Shaving Soap. So this was a shaving cream. All gone, you can see, all gone. Was a shaving cream that you just rubbed in and shaved off. It worked pretty well. I do like other shaving creams better. It did smell very good, but I didn't notice anything, like it didn't make my legs particularly hydrated or anything like that. So I'm going to keep the container's been cleaned out, so I'm going to keep it and exchange it for a face mask when I have enough empty containers. So next thing I grab is also a shave cream. This is the EOS shave cream, 24 hours of deep moisture, blah, 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 shave wet or dry. So this says you can shave dry. I don't believe that that's true unless you want to get cut up really bad. This is not a very hydrating shaving cream, at least to me. It took a lot to get a nice lather foam-ish whatever. I mean, it's not foaming. It's just kind of a lotion, but it did take quite a bit to get into the skin so that it would be effective when I ran the razor over it. This is like the second one I've used of these, I think. It's okay. It's not great. It's okay. I would repurchase it again, but there are some stuff I like better. So if it's like on sale or something, then I'd get it. Okay, so this is a perfume. This is a little sample of the Chloe perfume. I do have a full size, not a full size. I do have a roller ball of this with the rest of my perfume, so I do like this one. Okay, so here's a makeup item. This is a Smashbox 24-hour photo finish shadow primer. So I've had pretty negative experiences with this product overall. I've only ever tried these small little sample sizes, but both times that I've tried it, this has happened. Where can you see how it's just split? So I ended up trying to squeeze out all of the stuff from here that was hopefully not exposed to the air up here, but it ends up making it really thick. It dries it out pretty bad. So I just kind of, I'm ready to toss it. And there's so many other things that I like pretty well that are probably not as expensive as this. So I'm not going to purchase this. And if I get another sample like this, I'm just going to pass it on to someone else because I'm kind of not impressed with that. Okay, so here's another Lush product. This is the Rose Argan Body Conditioner. And this, I believe, was... yeah, okay. So this was something that you rub into your skin. After you wash in the shower, you rub it into your skin. And you kind of let it gently rinse off and pat dry. So you don't want to, wipe it off. But you want it to just not be sticky. It's supposed to leave your skin feeling really hydrated. It was hydrating enough, but I get the same response from just standard lotions. So, I would use this again, but it wasn't necessarily so, you don't know what that means, you guys know. Okay, so this is the last big thing in here. This is, the Bath & Body Works Sweet Cinnamon Pumpkin Soap. So this one I used up over the fall when all of the pumpkin, scents come out, and that's one of my favorite times to be there because all the pumpkin stuff smells so good. And I love all the pumpkin stuff. So, absolutely would purchase this again come next fall. Okay, so next thing I probably pulled out is the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. And this is just a little sample size of it. This is supposed to set your makeup to make it last longer. You've tried this one and I've tried the All Nighter or the D-Slick. And I've never noticed a difference between when I use this and when I don't use this. So I've got another sample that I'm hurrying to use up just for the sake of using it up. But I don't hate it, but I don't notice anything spectacular when I use it. So It's there. Okay, so here's something I like a lot. This is the Ole Henriksen Truth Serum Collagen Booster with vitamin C. And I just have the little sample size here. I do have a full size of this in my skincare drawer that I'm going to get through once I used up all my vitamin C samples. But vitamin C is supposed to be really good for your skin as a serum. It's supposed to help fade acne scars, which I have a lot of. And I notice when I use vitamin C on a regular basis, my skin does look brighter over time. So I really like this. I do have a full size of this already. And when that's gone, I want to try the Paula's Choice one. So I may not purchase this exact one, but I'm definitely going after more vitamin C. But I'm definitely going after more vitamin C serums. Okay, so this is a hair bit, and this is the Fekai Soleil Hair Mist, Pre-Soleil Hair Mist with Invisible Sun Filter, Sunflower Seed Oil. This just smelled really good. It made my hair smell really good and helped to kind of calm the frizz a little bit. I do have another one of these in my hair care drawer, so I'll use that one up. I don't think I'll buy a full size of this, but I will use the other one up. Okay, so this one is the Thank Me Later Eyeshadow Primer. This one, I think it's by Elizabeth Mott. This I got in an Ipsy a while back, and I used it pretty consistently. And then it actually worked really, really well. I would compare it to my Urban Decay or my Too Faced. But then it kind of, I went back to see if it was still good. Most of it's empty. But then it kind of started separating a little bit. But that's what it looks like there. But it started to separate and there was so little left. And I have so many other primers that I just decided to kind of chuck it rather than risk it being bad and then being something that I wouldn't be putting onto my eyes because it was bad. Okay, so this is another one that I got in a box. I think I got this in BoxyCharm. But this is the Duca, I think? Punk Volumizer Mascara. So what it is it's this really, really bushy wand, and it's supposed to give you like the really thick spider eyes, and I did not like this at all. Every time I used it, it flaked really bad, it clumped really bad. I would get like flakes in my eyes when I used it, or the wand was so big that I'd be trying to put it on and I'd end up getting it like on my eyebrows or on my chin. Or on my cheek down here. So I used it quite a bit, trying to learn how to like it, learn how to use it, but I just ended up, I gave up. I have other things. I have so many other unopened mascaras that I need to go through that I'm not going to fuss with that. Okay, so the next is the Starlux Pro Luxe Longwear Eyeliner Pen. So this is a liquid liner, and it's just got that kind of a felt tip there at the tip. And it's a nice black liner. It's pretty good in terms of, like, it goes on pretty well. It doesn't stay, like, if I wing it out, it may smudge off by the end of the night, regardless of whether I use primer or not. But as far as, like, over the lashes itself, it stays okay. So, and it does, it doesn't smudge. But it's been getting drying out, so it's, like, skipping a lot. So I just decided since I have several other ones to use up that I'm just gonna pass this into the garbage and move on to other liquid liners. Okay, so this one is also from Lush, and it is the Breath of Fresh Air Toner Water. So I use this a lot. I use up this entire thing and then I filled it up with tea tree oil spray that's also from Lush. And both of those I liked a lot, and they did helps make my skin more bright, not necessarily more clear, like it didn't help acne necessarily, but it did make my skin more bright, so I would repurchase this at some point. Okay, here's another liquid eyeliner. This is the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner. So it's a little sample size, and if you can ever get a small little sample of the tattoo liners, try, because the full size is like $20, and these liquid, and these sample sizes last forever. They last literally like months. So that's this one down here, and it's got this brush tip. This is my favorite liquid liner that I've ever tried. And it's got that brush tip at the bottom, and it stays. If I do a wing for one of my 12-hour shifts, at the end of the shift, the wing is still there. So this is my favorite liquid eyeliner. I know it's a lot of people's favorites, so... I have two other backups of the small little ones, and if I can't find any more little ones, then I'll eventually purchase the big one. Alright, this one is from Neutrogena, and it is a Neutrogena Nourishing Eyeliner in the shade Brush Pewter. So this is a brownish gray. Let me see if I can get a swatch of it. So that's this one here, but it's just this brown-gray eyeliner that I would use when I wanted a more natural look. And I like this one because it has a little sharpener that plugs in here, and it's got a smudge. I love this little smudge on the back so you can, like, smear it out. Because what I would do is, like, I would line it along here, and then I'll take the smudge and just smudge it out into the inner rim, and that would make it look a lot more natural to me. So I wore this a lot to work when I didn't want to look like I was wearing a lot of makeup. Would absolutely repurchase this. This lasted a long time. It didn't bleed, like it didn't end up in my corners of my eye here like a lot of liners do. So I would absolutely repurchase this at some point. So the next thing I've gotten here is the Maybelline New York Brow Precise Micro Pencil. So this is Maybelline's trying to dupe the Brow Wiz. I bought this in July when I first did my hair red because I didn't have any auburn colored eyebrow pencils. So this is what I ended up using for a while. And let me see if I can get a swatch there for you. So you can see it kind of matched really well, and it made my eyebrows blend in a lot better to my hair because my eyebrows are naturally brown and they don't match my hair when I have it dyed like this. But I liked this a lot. It seemed to stay pretty well. I would set it with a gel and it'd be fine. And then it does have a spoolie on the end. And then the tip is a very thin, so you could see it's where it would come out there. It is very thin, so you can use it to like create the little hairs in the center. So I would purchase this again. I probably am going to, because with my hair so bright, my eyebrows are not matching, so I think I'm going to go find something auburn colored, because all of mine are currently a brown taupe blonde color. So this, it just says Nordstrom on it, but it is it's by Jo Malone. It's a fragrance by Jo Malone that was sea salt and something else. Sandalwood? Sea salt and sandalwood, I think. But it is the best perfume that I have tried in a very long time. And, oh, it smells so good. I use the sample up so fast, and I really want to get a full size, but the full size is like $120. So what I'm doing is working through all of my perfume samples, and once I've got all my samples cleared out, then I'll let myself buy probably like the 1 ounce. That's only like $60, but buy one of these. So that's definitely on my wish list there. Okay, so this is the skincare. This is the e.l.f. Acne Fighting Gel Acne Treatment, and it has 1% salicylic acid in it. So it's a little roller ball at the top, and then there's gel along the inside here. And you just, how I use it is I wash my face, then I'll like spot treat, and then I'll do the gel on my eye, not this gel, but like my eye cream on, give it some time to set in, and then I'll do my serums and my moisturizer. And it does seem to help treat the, reduce more aggressive acne. So I have 2 or 3 backups of this already. Okay, so the next thing is a Marc Jacobs, lip gloss here. This is one of the few lip glosses I actually like. This is in the shade Kissability. The last time I looked, this was one of those shades that you can only get in like one of his kits, and he doesn't sell this one individually along with his other lip glosses. I'll have to check again, and if I'm wrong, I'll make some sort of annotation or something. but I really like this one because it's a very neutral color, and it feels nice on the lips. I really like Marc Jacobs because it has that cooling sensation on the lips. This is the second one of this Kissability shade that I've gone through, and I have another one sitting behind me, so really like this one. Okay, the last two things I have are mascaras. This one is by Blink Mascara. It's the Amplified. Let me just say it's Amplified. But it's the one that's supposed to tube your lashes. So this is what the wand looks like. So it's nice in terms of like it makes your lashes look nice, but when it dries, it settles on this little tube around each lash, so it's easier to take off. So you can just like take your remover and a cotton pad and just like rub, and then it comes off in little tubes, which is nice for taking it off at the end of the day. But during the day, I was getting flakes in my eyes. Like I was constantly having little bits of mascaras in my eye, and it was driving me up the wall. And so I didn't even finish this, I just gave up. Okay, and the last thing I've got here is the L'Oreal Voluminous False Fiber Lashes. This one I kind of encountered the same thing where if there's anything that's gonna come off of it, it's gonna get in my eyes. And I didn't hate this. Like it was okay the way it looked. There's the brush for you. But I prefer really natural looking lashes more so than like the really, really thick ones. And these do a more natural looking, but this tube just got old, so that's the biggest reason why I'm tossing it out. But I probably would not purchase it again because there's other mascaras I like better, but I didn't hate this. So, all right, that's all I've got for right now. I'll do another one when I fill this box up again with more stuff. And then if you want to see anything else, then just stick around and eventually I'll post another thing like this.